Unfettered by the strictures of tradition, Singaporean ink artists have been able to draw great value from ancient traditions of Chinese art and work with them creatively to produce artistic expressions unique to their circumstances. This series will explore how Chinese techniques and formats developed through the centuries came to be reworked by Singaporean artists. Chinese painting first evolved into a distinct art form separate from earlier types of artistic expression in the Six Dynasties period. Painting in China became consolidated into a single tradition, what we call Chinese painting, by the Song Dynasty. A series of invasions of the Song territories helped develop the idea of a Chinese nation, and Song artists used painting as a way to express this identity. There were two major traditions of Chinese painting that developed at this time: figure painting and landscape painting. Figure painters such as Li Gonglin and Liang Kai were inspired by ideas about morality and painted scenes that were lessons in moral behavior. These painters were usually inspired by older art forms such as religious murals and used them as a source of authority. A less direct expression of painters' anxieties emerged in a new genre of landscape painting, where artists such as Guo Xi and Xia Gui used mountains and rivers as symbols of their thoughts and emotions, as well as representations of the ideal secluded life. In the Ming and Qing dynasties, paintings in these two traditions became associated with the literati class and became the predominant art forms in China. In late Qing Shanghai, artists such as Ren Bonian and Wu Changshuo painted in bold and individualistic ways to compete for the commercial market's attention. These paintings favored bright, pleasing colors and everyday subject matter, and became known as the Shanghai School. The 1911 revolution ended imperial rule and gave birth to modern China. Ink painting became acknowledged as the national art form of modern China and was known as Guohua. Modern artists such as Xu Beihong, Lin Fengmian, and Wu Guanzhong took ideas from Western and Japanese paintings to modernize the traditional art form. The first professional ink artists in Singapore were Guohua artists. Many of them moved to Singapore in the 1930s due to the Japanese invasion of China and held exhibitions to sell their works here, donating the profits to fund the Chinese war effort. The most famous of them was Xu Beihong. Unrest in China meant that many antique paintings started to flow out of China and into Singapore. Collectors such as Lo Chak Tiu, Yu Ki Lim, and Tan Si Chow built their collections by buying boxloads of ancient paintings cheaply, saving them from destruction. These collections were important sources of inspiration for Singaporean ink painters. As the Singaporean Chinese community at the time started to see themselves as distinct from their fellow Chinese in China, art forms, including painting and literature, began to be localized and fine-tuned to better express the feelings of the Singaporean Chinese and their Southeast Asian surroundings. For example, Chen Wenxi was inspired by his trip to Bali in 1952 with other artists, and they together created a uniquely local style, later called the Nanyang style. More recently, ink artists are moving away from the Nanyang style and finding their own ways to express their identities. Artists including Henry Chen and Tan Kian Por found ways to renew ancient ink techniques, while others such as Chua Yi Kei, Hong Sek Chen and Tay Bak Chang innovated on traditional ink formats. In Singapore, artists do not find themselves restricted by formal ink training and tradition, even as some artists continue to use ink as an expression of their Chinese identity. The difficulties in striking the perfect balance between tradition and contemporary ideas has not stopped Singaporean artists from pursuing their own ink expressions, and artists who creatively use the ink medium to reinterpret this ancient art form have become a mainstay of our art world.